boys and girls. Today we're going to visit a town in Northern Ireland beginning with R. Do you know any towns in Northern Ireland beginning with R? It's Randalstown. Yes, not far from Antrim, Port Glenone, Toombridge. And there we have a lovely little country town called Randalstown. Many years ago, there used to be a railway track going through this now, a viaduct. And my friend Gary, who is lives in, and I've known Gary for a long time, and he lives in Randalstown, is going to go over the history and the present, what's going on in Randalstown. Before that, let's sing this great song, and look out for the train, it could be coming all my life. Favorite over the summer. Let's go and visit my friend Gary, and he's going to walk us through and talk us through Randalstown. Here we go.
G'day boys and girls, today we are in Randalstown, and this is my friend Gary. Gary, say hello to the boys and girls.
Hello boys and girls.
So Gary, where is Randalstown?
Well, Randalstown is County Antrim. It's about 20 miles from Belfast. It's a very central location. We have the M2 motorway straight to Belfast. We're very close to the international airport. We have the local hospital, Antrim Area Hospital. So it's a very central place to live, Colin.
And what other towns are connected to Randalstown?
Well, you have Antrim, which is about 4 miles down the road, Toombridge and Ballymena as well.
Port Glenone?
Port Glenone as well, yeah, and Ahuachal.
Ahuachal. Is there primary schools in this area?
Yeah, there's a number of primary schools. We've got Randalstown Primary, we've got Dunedin Primary, Grogan Primary, and also Mount St Michael's Primary, just across the bridge here.
And what bridge is this, Gary? We're looking at very beautiful.
Yeah, well, this is the River Main, and this is the viaduct, very famous viaduct in Randalstown. And if you just look over here, this was the site of the old bleach factory, which back in the day was a large employment catch in the area, and it was first opened in 1856, and it was first a cotton mill, but then Charles Webb made it into a linen factory, and unfortunately it closed in 2002. And if you look, even down, as you go down the river,
the big chimney,
there's the big chimney, and also there's other buildings which were connected to the linen factory.
That's the river main. Is it people fishes or anglers?
Anglers
in the river?
Yes, there's anglers here. If you see the viaduct there, if you go on up, you're going into Lord and Neil's estate, Shane's Castle estate. So yes, there's anglers here all the time fishing.
Lord and Neil's estate. Do you know anything about it?
Yeah, Lord and Neil's estate. It's a lot of historical significance, and I'm not just actually sure the size of it, but it's a massive estate. But even back during the First World War, there was part of the estate which was called Dunmore Park. And during the war, they made it training areas to train the soldiers before they would go out to France and Belgium to fight in World War I. So in Northern Ireland, there was five barracks built, and one of them was connected to Shane's Castle estate. Lord O'Neill actually gave 50 acres of land to the army, and there was a training base built which could hold upwards on 5,000 men.
Wow.
Who were trained before they went out to France and Belgium. They were able, the River Main was there, they were able for fresh water, there was the forest they were able to do their training in, and there was actually also trenches made as well for the soldiers to train in the trenches, giving them an idea of what it was going to be like before they left here.
Wow, I never knew that.
Yeah.
Gary, you keep mentioning viaduct. Is that a bit of duck? What is a viaduct?
The viaduct, you can see the viaduct here. The viaduct was built in 1856. It was built in 1856 to accommodate the railway line which run through Randalstown. And the railway line run through Randalstown from 1848 to 1950. And actually, the railway actually run across the top of the viaduct on its way to Cookstown.
Is there a good community spirit in Randalstown, Guy?
Yeah, there's good community spirit. Actually, where we're standing at here today, like, and if you walk around the town and even up on the viaduct, there's a group in Randalstown called Tidy Randalstown, which is a community-based organisation, and all these flowers, all the things that you see around the town, it's them that has done all this work. And Randalstown has actually won a number of prizes in best kept small towns during the last number of years.
You're a Christian guy.
I am indeed, yes.
Is that a made you smile? Is that important for you?
Yeah, it's very important to me, so it is.
Why is that?
Well, today there's a lot of people searching for hope. There's a lot of people trying so many different things. But I thank God that I have the greatest hope, which is the Lord Jesus Christ, great assurance. And as a child, I accepted Christ as my Saviour.
As a child, Gary, you're a busy man. You drive a lorry, you're involved in community work.
Yeah.
But you're also involved reaching children for Christ. Is that important to you?
Very important. I think today, when we look at our society, and even the breakdown of society, and even in schools, perhaps it's getting harder for the RE to be taught in schools. I think it's so important to reach boys and girls at a young age and to share with them the great message of the gospel. They in turn then can take that message home to their parents as well.
But from your experience, can children believe in God and enjoy learning about God?
Absolutely. Children love hearing about the gospel. They love hearing the Bible stories. And as you begin to tell a Bible story and you begin to tell them about the Lord, they just sit there and they're like wee sponges. They soak it all in. So they,
Gary, on a lovely day like this here, looking at the river, you're talking about flowers and plants. Does it help you think about God?
Of course it does. Everywhere you look, you see God's creation. And in Randalstown, we're very blessed. The group has done a lot of work in getting all the flowers, all the plants, everything done. But you know, I always think, what was the Garden of Eden not like? I don't think our mind really can take it in. But no matter where we are, and especially in such a sunny day like this here, you just see God's creation everywhere. Absolutely everywhere. And it's great just to have God as your saviour.
I remember years ago, Gary, come with yourself when I come through Randalstown to have children's Bible clubs.
Yeah.
And every year, do you have good memories of that?
Brilliant memories. Brilliant memories.
Is that important to keep reaching children every year?
Keep reaching the children every year at every opportunity. And it's amazing how there was people who, many years ago, who were sitting in tents doing the Bible clubs, and now their parents themselves, and now they're sending their children to Bible clubs. So it has that knock-on effect, so it does.
So even though, Guy, you're an adult, you've made lots of money, you're a busy man, God's still important to you?
He's more... Listen, it doesn't matter what we have in this life. It's only what we have in the Lord's work. That's all that counts. And you know, at the end of the day, when we pass from this scene of time, the most important thing is to know that we're going to heaven.
So it's not, life's just not important. It's not everything. Going to school, getting a good education, getting a good job, making lots of money. For you, there's more to it than that.
So much more. You could have all that, and you could be the poorest person in this world. If you have the Lord Jesus Christ as your own personal saviour, you're the richest person.
So if a child sitting listening wants to know, how can I be normal and be a Christian? In a simple way, what they have to do that?
What you have to do is, you know when God will be speaking to you, and you will have that personal experience. You will have that personal experience of the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will know when you accept him as your saviour that something has happened in your life. There's a change in your life, and that change is the Lord Jesus.
Oh, you have a favourite Bible verse, Gary?
Yeah, John chapter 3, verse 16. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Why is that your favourite?
Because it tells me that Christ loved me so much, he gave his Son. And it doesn't matter who it is, it doesn't matter where they're from or what they've been involved in, Christ Jesus gave his life on the cross for their sin and for my sin.
Wonderful. And Guy, Randalstown's a busy town with lots of business shops.
Yeah, busy, really busy. Busy time. So.
And some people go to Port Stewart and Port Rush for the holidays, but why not come to Randalstown? Would you recommend it?
Yep, come to Randalstown. We've got the viaduct, we've got the river, plenty of nice walks around Randalstown, and plenty of ice cream shops, which is most important.
Ice cream?
Ice cream.
Boys and girls, we have to go, Guy. Just mentioned ice cream. Thanks for watching. That was very interesting, Guy, from Randalstown. Really, really appreciate
right,
it.
Thank you.
Gary, thank you so much for your knowledge, for talking us through Randalstown, a beautiful country town in County Antrim there. We're going to finish off with a wee song. Gary, of course, busy man, but he loves working with children, reaching the children, teaching them about God, about the Lord Jesus. And we thought we'll sing a wee song. It's good to have Gary and Helen with us in the picture today. And of course, when Gary was a wee boy, he didn't realise we recorded him singing, and in one of the verses on his own. But sing along here, Jesus loves the little children. Finish with, did you notice Gary driving his little oil truck? Yes, we're going to make a video someday of Gary the oil man. But that's all from Randalstown today. Enjoy the rest of your day, and thank you so much for watching.